Okay, good evening to you all. So today we are going to discuss anti-Parkinson's disease, anti-Parkinson's drugs. Yesterday we were discussed about in detail about the disease condition, what are the signs and symptoms of Parkinsonism. Parkinsonism is also known to be a EPS, extrapyramidal symptoms. It's a motor disorder. Usually it happens in old age. There is a geriatric disorder, geriatric problem. But once even young people also, the too young or the adult persons also, they suffered with these symptoms, extrapyramidal symptoms. Why they suffered these symptoms? What are the clinical conditions? So what are the, you know, the reasons? So that is also the clear mechanism is unknown. But as on date, because see, I said, if you have the clear mechanism of action, clear pathophysiology of the disease, easily we can have the treatment. If you don't have pathophysiology, I mean, what is the cause about their mechanism, it's very difficult to treat. But we have some old drugs to managing this extrapyramidal symptoms. We are controlling. So, as like, you know, psychiatric disease. So, psychopharmacological agents, because various psychopharmacological agents are made available to control various psychiatric diseases. Psychosis, I mean, schizophrenia, mania, depression, anxiety. So, on subtypes of various, you know, the manic, bipolar manic disorder. So, various, the psychiatric diseases are, we are treating with the help of, you know, drugs. That too, we are controlling signs and symptoms of that disease. Totally, we are not, you know, eradicating. If you take this, okay, 1 week or 10 days, surely we cannot say that, okay, it is treated, because it is a disorder. That's what I said. It's a disorder. Say endocrine disorder. How do we say endocrine disorder? That means hormonal disorders. So due to the hormones are, you know, either dysfunction or maybe there is no production. So it leads to the diabetes. It leads to the hypo or hyperthyroidism, or it leads to the Addison's disease, like, you know, various kind of, you know, endocrine disorders. Here also we had the neurological disease. Here we can specifically say neurotransmitter disorder. This Parkinson's disease, schizophrenia, depression, mania. Can you follow me? Able to follow me, ma'am? Yes? Okay. So, this kind of schizophrenia, there's various psychiatric diseases also we can called name neurotransmitter disorder. So, I'd say that, you know, endocrine disorder, hormonal disorder. See, if it is pathogenic infection, microbial infection, easily we can have the treatment. Because we know the cause of the disease. We know the reason of pathophysiology, easily we can have antimicrobial. But these disorders are, for example, hormonal disorder, as already I said, we should take only the replacement therapy. Or we'll have to, we have to say some substitution therapy. Instead of that, okay, we'll have this, okay, to stimulate this insulin. So, anti-diabetic drug, oral anti-diabetic drug, isn't it? Because, see, insulin hormone, it is not secreted insulin. So, become diabetes. So, in that case, what you are doing, we are taking readymade insulin injection. Second thing, we are taking some other drug to increase the insulin function. That is oral anti-diabetic drug. So, like this, somehow we are managing. So, this is all psychiatric, because it is a motor disorder, it's a brain disorders. So, these diseases are that because of, you have to keep it in this word, neurotransmitter disorders. Because, you see, I said if it is the one, or even yesterday we were discussed, because old age people, the last class we were discussed about, is geriatric. Once age of 70, 80 plus, they'll get these tremors. restlessness, excitement, mental confusion, amnesia, you know, abnormal, you know, facial movements, you know, that, you know, constant chewing, puffing of cheeks, lip licking, you know, that means they'll get, you know, the restlessness, agitation, tremors, especially. You can find especially old age people. So these symptoms are collectively we can call as Parkinsonism. Then why this disease happens? That's what I said, neurotransmitter disorder. So why neurotransmitter disorder? That is clear mechanism is unknown. Why it is neurotransmitters, it causes abnormal. That is various risk factors we can list out. Okay, various risk factors, various reasons we can say. So other disease will induce Parkinsonism. Drugs induce Parkinsonism. So, or maybe some hormonal influences. Suppose if you are not taken healthy food, so also it may leads to the Parkinsonism. Because all hormones, enzymes, you know, these neurotransmitters are biosynthesized from the amino acids. So, poverty. So, starvation. That is starvation also it leads to the, there is no efficient formation of biosynthesis of hormones, enzymes and this neurotransmitter. So, like, you know, you can call many reasons, but majorly, so you know what to say, the drugs induced Parkinsonism, that too especially antipsychotic drugs are induced Parkinsonism. If it means anti-Parkinsonism, because next unit we have this, you know, psychiatric medications under you know, neuropharmacology, antipsychotic drug. So once we are taking antipsychotic drug, for example, the patient suffering, one person suffering with, you know, the schizophrenia symptoms at the age of 30 years. So, overall taking the antipsychotic drug, so for them they'll face this type of symptoms, that is extra pyramidal symptoms, EPS symptoms, simply you can call EPS symptoms. Why? Because I'll tell you the reason. Okay, so this is about Parkinsonism. So, here, even yesterday I said, you know, last class we had discussed about neurotransmitter. Yes, neurotransmitters are the major, you know, unit will maintains the our psychology. Because in detail we will discuss under psychopharmacology about neurotransmitter concept. Because here, specifically I said, dopamine neurotransmitter is responsible for this Parkinsonism, normal pyramidal symptoms, normal motor activity. Because naturally, it is, dopamine is a natural, you know, the neurotransmitter. But if it is abnormal, it is in the level of, you know, dopamine. Just imagine dopamine, because even last class what we had discussed, because there are two types of neurotransmitter, excitatory neurotransmitter, inhibitory neurotransmitter. So, who have this balanced form of this excitatory and inhibitory neurotransmitter, so they have the healthy mind. Okay, excitatory, just like weighing balance, if you have these two are balanced form, excitatory and inhibitory neurotransmitter, will have the healthy mind as per neurotransmitter concept. Okay, so here the dopamine is a specific neurotransmitter responsible for this Parkinsonism psychosis. So why it is dopamine? Because dopamine, just imagine excess of dopamine, it leads to psychosis. Less or hypofunction of dopamine leads to Parkinsonism. That's what you see in the definition itself. I wrote it. You see, you can able to see in slide Parkinsonism hyphen. So overall, see that means here the Parkinsonism hyphen, just I put this, you know, decreases symbol DA and increases symbol ACH, acetylcholine. Can able to see that in slide, it has clearly I mentioned, that's what for reference purpose. Suppose you reference textbook is not given for understandings. That's what even last class all said. If you understand this clear, you know, this only single concept. So, decreases or hypofunction of dopamine leads to Parkinsonism. Keep it in mind. Once again, I'll repeat this. decreased or hyperfunction of dopamine neurotransmitter activity leads to Parkinsonism or EPS symptoms. So dopamine, it's a decreased or hyperfunction of dopamine neurotransmitter, it leads to Parkinsonism. Then what we have to do? Our drugs will helps to increases. Okay, our drugs will helps to increases or stimulate dopamine neurotransmitter activity. The very simple, you know, understanding. The clear, you know, very simple. Because see, if you're referring, even I uploaded notes, many that, you know, like flowchart reactions I written. Nothing it is. But is, if you understand this concept, you can remember the classification, you can remember the mechanism of action. See, uses, side effect, pharmacological action, everything as it is. See, nothing is new, I can explain. But here I have the space to explain more on the, about, you know, that especially mechanism of action and the reason for the disease. So remaining things, see, nothing I need to explain about uses and side effect or something is, you know, the pharmacological action. As it is, I can, but here you have to, I want to just clarify clearly. So reason for disease, how we can rectify. Overall, maybe that is as a pharmacologically, you have to say that what is the reason for that disease. So how we are rectifying with the help of drug. Here the Parkinsonism we are rectifying with the drugs. What the drug will do in the sense, very simple and understanding. So the drug will increases the dopamine activity in brain. And second, I'll repeat, these anti-Parkinsonism drugs are will goes and increases or stimulate the dopamine neurotransmitter activity in brain, or it activity in the, specifically if you want to say, increase the dopamine neurotransmitter activity at nerve terminals and to control the acetylcholine action. Because if you see in the old age people, they'll excess of saliva, just like, you know, the excess of salivary, slurred speech. Okay, so that means they felt excess of salivation, the slurred speech. So these are the, as you know, that problem of, you know, autonomic nervous system. Because already I said this, acetylcholine, it causes excess of salivation, means salivary secretions. So this also it helps to control, therefore, by mild anti cholinergic action. But here it is a majorly we have to increase in the dopamine neurotransmitter activity. This is understood. Because nothing I complicated, I said here, I said, because Parkinsonism is a disease due to the decreased or, you know, hyperfunction of dopamine neurotransmitter activity, it become EPS symptom. So we are going to have the treatment. The treatment is the drugs we have. These drugs will go and increases the dopamine activity at nerve terminals, I mean in brain. Okay, this is called as anti-Parkinsonism drugs. It's understood, ma? See, yes or no? Because see, if you understand, only simple. See, if you refer in textbook in Tripathi or anything, so they'll, something is, you know, detailedly as given. This is the exact concept here. Okay, next I'll pass on to classification. Because based on this only, classification also it is classified. Okay, first one, drugs affecting brain dopaminergic system. See, you that namings and all you may heard first time, you'll get to, don't think it as very complicated system. Very, very simple. If you understand clearly the concept, easily you can remember mechanism, action, even classification. See, that means here drugs affecting brain dopaminergic system. Dopaminergic, nothing but dopamine neurotransmitter. Because generally, neurotransmitters are synthesized, biosynthesized and released in the neurons. Because, as I said, it's a brain disorder. So, because the basic unit of, you know, CNS system is neurons. So, this from the neurons only synthesized the numerous, you know, the neurotransmitter. Okay. So, drugs affecting brain dopaminergic system. First one, dopamine precursor. Okay, dopamine precursor. So example, levodopa. Because already in first unit, we have discussed about L-dopa. It's a very good prodrug. Okay, prodrug. What is my prodrug? What is meant by prodrug? Yes, anybody? Yes, tell me. What is meant by prodrug? I said it's a two mask question. Please, anybody speak? Are you there in online? Okay. Some more explanation. What will do? What happens after entering this prodrug? No, it is not active drug. See, prodrug is an inactive form. After entering to the site of action, at the target of action, it converted to active. That means inactive form converted to active form. Okay. So dopamine precursor levodopa is a precursor. It is made it as levodopa. Prodrug form. Prodrug nature is, it's an actual, basically it is a inactive form, nothing is pharmacological action. Once entered into our target, for example, this levodopa once entered into brain is converted to, dopamine. Okay, it is there, we'll see next. So, dopamine precursor. Next, decarboxylase inhibitor, especially peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor. Peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor. Here it is understand that it inhibits the decarboxylase enzyme. We will see later what is why we should inhibit this decarboxylase enzyme. What is the role of this enzyme? Okay. Next, dopaminergic agonist. So, dopaminergic agonist, it is understand that it agonist means, as everyone you know, that it increases or stimulate the or favoring to the pharmacological action, increases the another drug action, increase the other actions, increase the physiological action. Clear? So, here increases the dopamine neurotransmitter, because here we want dopamine action. See, even first topic also, dopamine precursor, what it is. So, precursor means it's inactive. Well, once it goes entered into the site, entered into the target, site of action, it is become active. For example, all, the metabolic reactions are, we can call as precursor. See, some, for example, monosaccharide, glucose, it converted to 6-glucose phosphate. So, this, it converted to become other form. So, that means here, the levodopa, it converted to dopamine. See, readily we are producing the dopamine. That's what I said, we have to keep it mind that point. But our aim is, we have to increase the dopamine neurotransmitter activity. By readily we are taking, or by directly or indirectly, we are improving the, or increasing the dopamine neurotransmitter activity. Okay. See, the dopamine precursor, we are taking ready-made dopamine, and decarboxylase inhibitor, due to inhibition of that enzyme, it preventing to, degradation reaction. It is their reaction. I think you may have seen in notes also, I already uploaded. Dopamine agonist, it is there that some group of drugs will improve the or increases the dopamine neurotransmitter activity. Next, MAO. Actually, MAO means, you can call as MAO, MAO. Monoamine oxygenase inhibitor, then COMT inhibitors. See, these are the enzymes. So, dopaminergic enzymes, the brain enzymes are there to deactivate the dopamine to other form. Keep it in mind, monoamine oxygenase, the abbreviation M for mono, A for amine, O for oxygenase, subtype, because there are two types of enzyme, A and B. Okay, MAO B inhibitor, COMT, it's one more the enzyme inhibitor. So, these two are the drugs which inhibit this enzyme, just like decarboxylase inhibitor. So, MAO inhibitor means it inhibits that monoamine oxidase enzyme. This affects to prevent the conversion of another.
So COMT inhibitor, these are drugs to inhibit the COMT transmembrane enzyme to prevent the degradation of dopamine, because here we wanted more dopamine, because some of the enzymes will degrade the dopamine activity, dopamine level. Understood, ma? Why you? Okay. See, because that's what I said repeatedly, you have to keep that point. Our aim is you have to improve the or increase the dopamine availability, increase the dopamine actions by directly or indirectly. Here directly ready-made we are taking levodopa, after entering system become convert to dopamine. Second, some enzyme inhibitors we are taking, because decarboxylase, monoamine oxidase and transferase, that is COMT, these three enzymes are will degrade the dopamine level, so we should inhibit logically. Then dopaminergic agonist. See, these drugs are improves the, see, bromocriptine. See, example, bromocriptine is a drug. The drug is improves the dopamine. So already you know that meaning of the agonist. One drug is increase the another drug action. Here bromocriptine on drug improves the dopamine action. Okay, that is agonist. That dopamine facilitator, in the name itself you can understand, clear meaning is there. It facilitates the dopamine, because deficiency of dopamine, that's what in bracket I wrote it clearly. So always you have to remember that. Parkinsonism, I put hyphen, down arrow mark dopamine. Low dopamine, so become Parkinsonism. Here we have to facilitate increases as soon as possible, we have to improving the dopamine activity. Okay, this is understood, no? Because see, if you understood this concept, easily can remember the mechanism of action. Next, regulator 2, drugs affecting brain cholinergic. See, here is not peripherally, brain, because it's basically it's a brain disorder. So brain cholinergic system, particularly why you are taking this, anticholinergic, in the sense, that's what I said. So the excess of salivation, because you see the old age people, I'm taking just too old. 80 plus, 90 plus, so you'll get, accelerated speech, so that excess of salivation, excess of, even automatically it will affect the autonomic nerve functions also. So, and so here it is clearly, it is understand that central anticholinergic, antihistamines, some of the antihistamines will improve the, indirectly it improves the sleep cycle, sleeping. But we are not particularly taking this anticholinergic, antihistamine, but you can see, pharmacology in allopathy, whatever we have, the first thing we are aim is we have to control the signs and symptoms only. Many of the diseases are, we have the drugs only to control signs and symptoms. We don't have many drugs, we don't have any drugs for majority of the diseases. If you take any major disease, we don't have specific drug. Day by day we are changing. That's what many times myself also I said, so today this, tomorrow we don't know what new drugs will come. After 10 years, maybe whatever we talked here, maybe totally will be changed. So, because better than this, as a date, we have this controlling signs and symptoms, make your patient getting control. So, we are doing this. Suppose in future, some many studies are going on. If it is better than that, we'll change it. Why there is no medicine? Because we don't have specific, that replacement, because it's a disorders. Yes, very challengeable conditions, especially brain disorders. As you know that, because most of psychiatric diseases are, so time being only, if you take medicines only, we can control that time. After that, again, they'll change this, again, their behaviors, the mental functions, there will be remain same. Okay, so this is classification. It's a classification, nothing, it is very complicated, but you may, by studying, you may, names, you may get confusion, but very, very simple understanding. So these all group of drugs will improve the dopamine neurotransmitter activity, either directly or indirectly. Directly means directly we are taking the dopamine precursor and dopamine agonist and facilitator. Indirectly means due to some enzymes will degrade the dopamine level. So we should protect the dopamine from enzyme degradation. It's clear? Is it clear, ma? Okay. So this the description about levodopa. Actually, you see heading, I wrote it, mechanism of action of anti-Parkinsonism drug. Okay, but here actually this description about levodopa. Actually, next slide only mechanism of action, because here levodopa is a important repeated 5-mass question. Simply they'll give L-dopa. Okay, they won't ask any question. Or tried about L-dopa. Okay. Don't think it's totally its mechanism action, just levodopa description. Okay, just nothing I written, it's a very regular description. It is a precursor of dopamine ultimately, because is there next point why it is we are taking levodopa. Okay, it's a precursor of dopamine. Precursor, as you understand that, because it is a, you know, once if entered into this target of tissue or target of site of action, it converted to original form, converted to another form. Okay. It acts by getting, see clearly you read out, very simple language I used. It acts by getting converted into dopamine via enzyme called DOPA decarboxylase enzyme. That means levodopa, it converted to dopamine in presence of decarboxylase enzyme. This occurs both in peripherally and centrally after levodopa has crossed the blood-brain barrier. Because already we are in first introduction unit itself, we discussed the terminology prodrug. Prodrug means generally it is an inactive form. Once entered into the system, once entered into our site of action, get converted to inactive to active form. Because levodopa is the major problem of levodopa is, it is a, so that means see, major problem of dopamine. Actually here we attract dopamine only, isn't it? Because dopamine is the drug. Dopamine is the, you know, the drug of choice for this, you know, disorder for this Parkinsonism. Readymade, why can't we take readymade means? Because dopamine could not cross the blood-brain barrier. So they changed, modified in pharmaceuticals. L-dopa form it is taken. L-dopa easily can cross the blood-brain barrier. So after entering into the system, converted to a dopamine. Here, levodopa, nothing will produce action. It's, that's what is said is prodrug. Because I see here I never used prodrug, you can use it. See, nothing is wrong. Here, see, don't think it, why see here I done, but maybe see. While explanation only, we'll get many things we'll, you know, remember. Because all things I cannot, you know, mention it and, you know, suppose while writing I may forget it. That's what I said, there is no specific content to copy as it is. You can write by own, so you can make it maximum. One sentence, the way of presentation you can change it according to your convenience, but only concept has to understand. The main point is has to write. What is point? Here the levodopa is a prodrug for after crossing blood-brain barrier. Because see, this is brain disorder. We want action on brain. So the drug has to produce action on brain. So what happened, the problem of levodopa? Levodopa once before entering into the brain, sometimes become converted to dopamine peripherally. So, because naturally dopamine could not cross blood-brain barrier, so we are taken as prodrug form, as precursor form. So, this levodopa easily can cross blood-brain barrier after entering into the system, convert to a dopamine form. That's what only written. So, if this is convenient, you can write as it is. Or if you are write your own answer also, nothing is, you know, wrong. Okay. Because levodopa, it is the, like, you know, I said, it's a precursor. What do you say? You know, prodrug form. Okay. Next, mechanism of action. So, mechanism of action. Anti-Parkinson drugs, which increases the, see, this is the only single line action. Anti-Parkinson drugs, which increases the availability of dopamine neurotransmitter activity at dopamine receptors. Because naturally, whatever we have neurotransmitter is synthesized at the nerve terminals, neurons are releases, because biosynthesis neurons. So biosynthesized neurotransmitter releases the neural terminals, it passes on to postsynaptic nerve, bind with specific receptor. For example, dopamine biosynthesized from amino acid tyrosine. So it releases, after releases it bind with the postsynaptic nerve, dopamine receptor, then it produces action. What are the normal physiology? This is keep going on. But here the problem I already said, due to the various reasons, maybe dopamines are not, maybe biosynthesized, maybe not actually bind with receptor, maybe some enzymes will degrade. So, we are our aim of anti-Parkinson drugs are increases the availability or increases the action of dopamine neurotransmitter activity at receptor level. Nothing are written new. So there is no dopamine, we are increasing dopamine level. Simple. Okay, next point. This understood, ma? Yes. Okay. See, next point you see. See, this. See, if it is 5 marks question, only that sentence is enough. See, if it is my, if they'll ask, you know, 5 marks question. So, only anti-Parkinson's disease, levodopa to increase the availability of dopamine neurotransmitter to that dopamine receptors at postsynaptic nerve endings or in brain simply. Increase the dopamine neurotransmitter activity in brain, that is called as, that is the action of dopamine in, what is it, levodopa. Okay. If long essay, if you have time even for 5 months, you write in detail, it is better. Okay. Next one. Decarboxylase inhibitors like carbidopa and benzerazine are given with levodopa. So usually, theoretically, I said look at different classification, but clinical area we are using levodopa with carbidopa only. If you mean levodopa, we are using along with carbidopa. We will tell you reason why it is there. Okay, decarboxylase inhibitors like carbidopa and benzerazide are given with levodopa. Why? Because they decreases the peripheral decarboxylation of levodopa. Once again, so they decreases the peripheral decarboxylation of levodopa. Because you see the down reaction, levodopa in presence of decarboxylase hyphen become dopamine. See, just now I said levodopa converted dopamine, it is good for disease. But why we should inhibit this enzyme? Reason, see. So, more levodopa can enter into the brain for getting converted into dopamine. But before entering, because one more major problem of this levodopa, okay, major problem of, can able to follow? This more problem of levodopa. See, we want action at brain only. We don't want any action on peripherally or maybe in the other system. We want dopamine action on brain only. We don't want this action on the any other than brain. So major problem of this levodopa before entering into, suppose we are taken orally. See, it entered into this stomach, maybe dissolution, disintegration, taken absorption, metabolism. So, before reaches this brain, here itself get converted to dopamine. Okay, before reaching into the brain, can you follow me? Before enter into the brain, this levodopa gets, slide, it down, you see, in peripherally. Periphery is written, no? See, levodopa before entering into the brain, levodopa converted dopamine. Yes, that's what even classification it has given. Peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor. Because just now I said dopamine, levodopa get converted to dopamine. So it is good for the disease. Then why we should use decarboxylase inhibitor? But that too, I never written centrally decarboxylase, that is peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor. See here, this slide. See, purpose of using peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor. You see this in this slide. See, right side I written peripherally. For example, external administration. You can able to read this? It's visible now, clearly. Yes? No? Please, all just you watch this slide, right hand side top. external administration. So that means levodopa tablet you have taken. Okay. Please respond. Hello. Okay. See, that means you have taken tablet form. Arrow mark I put under and down I have written decarboxylase become DOPA. So this right left side is brain. This process is going on brain. What process is going on means now we come to this left hand side brain. Because naturally I said this is natural neurotransmitter, naturally synthesized in our, you know, in the body, that is on neurons. See how it is biosynthesis means. So this maybe this dopamine synthesized from tyrosine. See tyrosine is from a dietary source, no, because amino acids from protein source, that is amino acids from dietary source, amino acids taken into the inside of the neurons. So neurons will take absorption. Tyrosine converted DOPA, DOPA is converted to dopamine. This dopamine release the, see I'm reading out this reaction. Dopamine release the nerve terminals DA, I put round, no, DA short form of dopamine, then bind with the D1, D2, D3, that is dopamine receptors. What is meant D1, D2, D3 means dopamine receptor, bind with dopamine receptor, it like further, you know, the ongoing process. This is an normal natural physiology, presynaptic nerve, postsynaptic nerve, this is normal process. We come to this again, right hand side peripherally. So external administration of levodopa. See, this is in brain is natural process because already is down, no, because we have no dopamine. We are taking levodopa form. Okay, we are taking tablet. So levodopa converted dopamine. Before entering into the brain, levodopa get degraded with decarboxylase. What happened? This decarboxylase will degrade the dopamine. Again, dopamine, no, it cannot cross blood-brain barrier. So this is one disturbances of levodopa. Hence, we have to take decarboxylase inhibitor. That too, peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor. Keep in peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor. Yes, I not written centrally. Even classification, you see, after that I added peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor. What is mean by peripherally decarboxylase inhibitor means levodopa is a very good precursor, very good drug for, you know, Parkinsonism. Naturally, what will happen? So, levodopa, just now I said explanation, inactive form convert to active. Levodopa easily can cross as blood-brain barrier. So, after that, what happens? It converts to dopamine. Good. This action we wanted on brain. But before entering into the brain, before crossing into the blood-brain barrier, because other processes are there, no? See, we have no any separate bypass to any brain. Once tablet entered means that is peripherally. See, just imagine head is brain. It is central, remaining portions are peripherally. So after entering your drug is in stomach, so it just reaches the liver, metabolism, so here and this and that, it goes and it then crossing the brain. So in peripheral system itself, this L-dopa become converted to dopamine. Because as usual, dopamine could not able to cross blood-brain barrier, so it is degrade, no? So that's what we are used to prevent that reaction. Peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor, example carbidopa, if you take this carbidopa, prevent this inhibit this enzyme, then so there is no formation of dopamine in peripherally. Okay, why it is specifically mentioned peripherally is because trustly I am explaining you in the sense, so you should, you know, again, no, don't get confusion, because in brain again L-dopa converted to dopamine in presence of decarboxylase only. So once this levodopa entered into brain means then L-dopa is converted to dopamine in terms of decarboxylase. That is centrally decarboxylase enzyme. This is peripherally decarboxylase enzyme. This reaction we don't want in outside brain. We want action in brain. No, we'll get confusion. Understood? So, hence, we are taking levodopa along with carbidopa. Ready-madely it's available nowadays. Carbidox, that means levodopa, readymadely the one single tablet contains levodopa plus carbidopa. Carbidopa, why? Carbidopa is a decarboxylase inhibitor. If you take this combination, levodopa as such, levodopa can cross the blood-brain barrier after entering into the brain.
what happen? It will convert it to active form. Okay. So as usual, this dopamine will release as postsynaptic nerve, bind with the receptors, so it produces normal pharmacological action. So in the down reaction, I wrote it. L-dopa means levodopa. Aroma decarboxylase. Why I put a minus mark in this? Because peripherally. Okay. So dopamine in brain. See in that you know that diagram also I wrote. No, in the structure of neuron. DA are written. I put MAO B. There I put minus. So DOPAC. This side you see right, left side. COMT enzyme. So it converted to 3-methyl thyromine. So these are all the enzymatic degradation. So we don't want that reaction. That's what we are taking MAO inhibitor, monoamine axis inhibitor, and COMT inhibitors. So what happened? If you are preventing this enzymatic degradation reaction, then whatever the biosynthesis dopamine directly bind with the D1, D2, I mean this dopamine receptor produce normal pharmacological action, physiological action. This is the mechanism. That means, hence what is the net action? Increases the availability of dopamine neurotransmitter activity at nerve terminals. It's understood? Just tell me, it's clear? Yes or no? Okay. Here nothing you will get, don't make it any confusions. Very clear. Naturally, dopamines are biosynthesis from tyrosine, become DOPA, dopamine, release dopamine, bind with the dopamine dopamine receptors. But the problem is, this monoamine oxidase and enzyme will degrade this dopamine level. Then COMT, one enzyme, you see that I'm talking about that structure I wrote, no, neurotransmitter structure there. COMT is, one enzyme, I put I minus symbol, so it convert to other form. So we should, that's what we are taking MAO inhibitors and COMT inhibitor. And peripheral decarboxylase inhibitor means because levodopa is the precaution for this Parkinsonism. So what happened before entering into the brain, levodopa get degraded or maybe converted to dopamine in process of peripherally. So you have to use the word peripheral decarboxylase. So here that reaction we don't want because we want to action in brain only. So what happens, this decarboxylase inhibitor carbidopa to prevent that reaction. So what happens is levodopa easily can cross the blood-brain barrier. So then dopamine, after entering into the brain, levodopa converted to dopamine, then it produces the actions. The same only I wrote it in simple, before I just, there I put, structure of neuron, so then presynaptic, postsynaptic, then down I written L-dopa, decarboxylase, dopamine. This after conversion of dopamine, it convert in presence of MAO and COMT, it become degrade the dopamine level. So our ultimate action of here to increases the action of dopamine at the nerve terminals. The same thing on the here also I written. See in two not necessary to write. So this now what you are able to see this slide is not necessary. Whether you write this or you write before I show, no? So, with the structure of neuron. Better you write with the structure of neuron that is process. Because both are the same only I written, L-dopa. There are three times it has come, no? Okay, so better you write with the structure of neuron. You start with, the tyrosine, dopa, dopac. So, you show that, but only thing is you have to show that. Monoamine oxidase, MAO, COMT, so that the decarboxylase enzyme. Because we want only action on brain, is because what happened, this dopamine in peripheral means it causes the more side effects. We want action in the brain only. Okay, so this is mechanism action. Today we'll finish it up because again we'll start explaining, we'll get confusion. So dopamine is anti, I'll conclude this today's topic. So anti-Parkinsonism are the drugs which helps in the management of Parkinsonism. Management of the extrapyramidal symptoms. So it's known to be anti-Parkinson's drugs. So before talking about drugs, here we should understand. So dopamine is a specific neurotransmitter. Actually, is an excitatory neurotransmitter. Okay. So dopamine is a specific neurotransmitter responsible for this EPS symptom, motor disorder, motor activity. If decreases dopamine activity, leads to Parkinsonism.
again next unit we have psychiatric drug. Just imagine, increases the dopamine level, it causes schizophrenia, psychosis, increased dopamine activity. What happened? If it is excess of dopamine, becomes schizophrenia, decreased dopamine leads to Parkinsonism. This concept you understand, because they are also like the same mechanism, same processes, the same structure of dopamine, some in neuron, tyrosine, dopa, dopamine, so dopamine bind with the receptor. But their antipsychotic drugs are dopamine antagonist, anti-Parkinsonism drugs are dopamine agonist. If you understood this, what is the meaning of dopamine agonist, dopamine antagonist, it's nearly understood. Because dopamine, here we want dopamine action in Parkinsonism, but in psychotic cases, we don't want dopamine, okay? According to that mechanism, action is classified, drugs acting on dopamine, dopaminergic drug, we are taking precaution, we are taking some enzymatic degradating drugs, so we are taking some dopamine agonist and facilitator, and in affecting cholinergic system, because of anticholinergic action. So we are taking some anticholinergic drug, because the main mechanism action of this anti-Parkinsonism drugs are to increases the availability of or increases the action of dopamine neurotransmitter at nerve terminals, in brain, because we want more dopamine activity. And the same side, we are degrading the some of the enzyme activity, like peripheral decarboxylase enzyme, next monoamine oxidase enzyme. So then this COMT transferase enzyme, because peripheral decarboxylase enzyme inhibitors are drugs to inhibit the peripheral decarboxylase. Why specifically use peripheral means, because levodopa is a drug of choice. So levodopa, it has to, one the purpose of using levodopa, easily will cross the blood brain barrier, then after entering the brain convert to dopamine. But before entering into brain, so and by system itself, peripheral itself, L-dopa converted dopamine. Keep it in mind, once peripherally available liberated dopamine, it causes side effect. There is no anti-Parkinsonism drug action. Unless it causes tachycardia, unless it causes BP, unless it increases the cardiorespiratory function. It is very good emergency drug, dobutamine, dopamine. Increase the blood pressure. Okay. So that's what we should block the dopamine activity. So the decarboxylase enzyme activity and other enzyme activity. So ultimate action is to increase the availability of or increase the action of dopamine neurotransmitter activity, the specific action of mechanism action of anti-Parkinson's drugs. So understood? Okay, up to this today we'll finish enough. Remaining we'll see tomorrow. First, at least try to write down notes. So tomorrow we'll keep with this. If you have doubts, again you ask me tomorrow. Thank you. Bye.